sign up, right? Write in your name, your email address, password, sign up, okay? So you don't have to write in your real name if you don't want to, right? Then you go to your email and click on the activation link, or you can just sign in. Okay, after you, you can also sign up with Facebook if you want. Maybe it's easier. Okay. So shouldn't take too long, just 1 or 2 minutes to sign up. Okay. Log in. So then type in, then go to log in and type in your email and your password. Click log in. Okay. So when you log in, how many people have logged in? How many people have not logged in? Okay. Just take another 30 seconds. When you log in, type in here negotiation. Or you can see here successful negotiation. Just in the top box. Search, right? Search box. Just type in negotiation. Okay. Then we're going to see the different courses on negotiation. Okay. So here you can take these different courses: the Art of Negotiation, Introduction to Negotiation, Yale. Okay. The one we're going to look at in this course is Successful Negotiation: Essential Strategies and Skills from the University of Michigan. Okay, this one, Successful Negotiation. So click on this course. Okay. Then I'm already signed up, but you have to join the course. Okay. So did you already join the course? So you can just click on full course, no certificate, and start learning, right? You don't have to pay any money, it's free to the public. Okay? Then you'll get this kind of page. Tells you about the course. Then you can scroll down and click on, we're already here on number two. Number two, prepare, plan your negotiation strategy. Okay. So we can see it has some reading and some video. So the video we did the last time was should I negotiate? This time we're doing position-based or interest-based negotiation or dispute resolution or deal-making negotiation today. Okay. So we won't be using this course all the time, just some things. It's like reading. Like book, right? But instead of book, it's video class. Okay? Didn't watch the videos yet, no. Just if you want, it's like, I'm going to explain these things to you in class, but it's like having a book. But instead of having a book, you have a website. Okay? So you can go home, if you have time, you can watch the video. They also have a transcript. So you click on this video, you can see this. And you can make an English subtitle, right?
Another person arguing, trying to persuade that other person.
You can make
often
a green subtitle.
The analogy is two gunfighters in the room, saying
right.
Who can draw the fastest, who has the best tools and techniques for persuading.
Do you want me to make a green subtitle for my class on YouTube?
Yes.
Takes a long time. So maybe hundreds of thousands of people take this course so they can get somebody to change the subtitle, okay? So, do you have any question about this website?
No.
So just, currently today is, should I negotiate a position-based one or dispute resolution or deal-making negotiation is the relevant part. So just we're using the computer room, so just I wanted you to register and understand about the website. Do you have any question? Then let's start the regular class. So just I asked you in the last class to do some negotiation. Okay, so discuss with your partner about your negotiation. Tell them, did you try to negotiate with somebody? Did you get any result? Okay, so first discuss with your partner. So when you come to the class, you guys should try to sit together because we're going to do some discussion exercise during the class. This was your assignment. And let's see, hands up, how many people negotiated, did the assignment? Hands up if you did a negotiation with somebody, if you tried. One? Just one person? How did it go?
Almost failed, but almost, actually I'm successful. Yeah, we should.
You were successful, that's a happy story. Can you tell us the story? What happened?
I was got a haircut in the last week.
Yes? That's a nice haircut?
No. Yes? She had really bad hair, so she ruined my hairstyle.
Okay, I hope she doesn't watch the video.
Yeah, so I want to negotiate the price of the haircut, but she says the price is fixed price. Mm-hmm. So. Then I think we should give some after service. Mm-hmm. So I got an after service.
Okay. What after service did you get?
She haircut again.
Put your hair again. More. Kept going. Okay. So what was your strategy? Tell her that she did a bad job and you weren't happy.
Pity?
You want to use pity? How did you feel?
Not good.
Well, you were successful in the end, right?
Yeah.
So, we can often find that people are successful, like you said on the TV program. If you try to negotiate, you could be surprised. Okay? Did anybody else try to negotiate? Yes?
Last year, I went to
Yes.
So, however, Chairman told if I give five and three, he will free.
Okay.
However, I want to buy three.
So you got some extra hand cream by negotiating. So you just asked directly. Did you use any strategy or just asking? Was it in department store? No. Street store. A little bit easier to negotiate there. So you went to Shanghai last week with your sister. Okay, that's nice. Okay. Anybody else try? So we have two examples of successful negotiation. Yes?
I bought some clothes. I don't like it. I want to sell. I want to sell. But two of my friends, or my friend on some general discount. So I told my friend, if you buy two clothes, I will give you some discount. So my friend agreed with me. So I sold two clothes.
You're quite the businesswoman. You're already selling things. Selling the clothes that you don't need, right? To your friends. Maybe you'll be very successful after 10 years. Right? So you negotiated with your friend and sold your clothes to your friend. Okay? So well done. Anybody else? Right, so last week we were talking about should we negotiate. So really depends on our feeling and on is it worth the time, right? So did you guys like negotiating? Do you feel okay negotiating? Yes. Okay. So we looked at one case the last time. Let's look at the other case here. So a college was offering a job to a professor and she replied by email saying that she wants to change some things. Okay? She said granting some of the following provisions. That's a formal way to say giving some of the following changes. Okay? Would make my decision whether to accept your job offer easier. Let me know. Okay? So for example, she asked, can they give her a higher salary? And she also asked, could she have no more than 3 new class preparations per year for the first 3 years? Okay? So the college search committee received the email and immediately replied, we decided to withdraw the offer of employment. Do you understand? Withdraw, take away the offer. Do you think the college professor was right to negotiate? Or not right to negotiate? Why not? She tried to negotiate about the job offer and they just took away the job offer. Do you think she was right or not? No?
Right.
Right, why?
She negotiated this situation. Mm-hmm. She had a career this time. Mm-hmm. If she don't change this time, she did not have career.
So she's thinking about her career. So maybe the job. If she doesn't get these things, it's not good for her career. She wants a higher salary, so it depends on the college professor, right? If she really doesn't want the job, she wouldn't take the job without a higher salary or without these conditions, then it's okay. But if she was interested in the job, and she was going to accept the job, but she just wanted to get a better deal, was she right to negotiate? Or not? Now she has no job. They took away the offer. So So you still think she was right to negotiate? Hmm? No, why not? Okay, so we have to think about, is it appropriate to negotiate or not? Okay? Is the situation appropriate or not for negotiating? In this case, it seems it wasn't very appropriate. Maybe she could have just accepted the job if she was interested in the job. Okay? She has to think, what is the risk? So you have to think, what is the risk about not getting any job, right? If I decide to negotiate, can the other person take away the offer? Okay, so we have to think about, is there any risk that the offer can be taken away? So to summarize, when we decide should I negotiate, we have to consider the risk and balance that against the benefit. So if the risk is too high, they could take away the job offer. I don't know them well, they don't know me well, okay? Then it depends, what is the benefit? Do I really want the job? Okay? Or I really need a higher salary? So we have to balance the benefit against the risk. Second, we have to consider our feeling about negotiating. Clearly, if you like negotiating, then you know, negotiating is better for you than somebody who feels very, very ashamed or so on. Then we have to do a cost-benefit analysis of the reward. We saw the case of the college professor who spent 20 hours researching to make $100 saving. That's not a good cost-benefit analysis, okay? He just got paid $6 for every hour he spent researching. Do you understand cost-benefit analysis? Have you seen that in another subject, like finance?
Yes.
Right, we have to look at the costs and look at the benefits and analyze. Do you guys spend a lot of time on the internet researching the price for different things?
Sometimes.
That's why I like Korea. You have a very easy way. You can go on Naver or Down Shopping, and after 3 seconds, you can list everything by price. It's very easy to find the cheapest one. So I don't have to spend a lot of time, and I get some good reward. So I like internet shopping in Korea. Usually nowadays, I buy everything, even my grocery food. I buy some pasta. I can find a bag of pasta for just 700 won on the internet. I have to buy about 20 bags, but that's okay. I can keep it for 3 or 4 months. But if I go to E-Mart, it's going to cost double the price, right? 1,500 won. But it only takes a few seconds. I just type pasta